checked in, I was asking you just to put some nice books on the table. Then you put first Italian book.
Indeed.
Because you're Italian.
I am.
And then
from Rome.
And then you put a European book.
True.
Now, a very sensitive question. If you have to decide, are you going to stay Italian or you are going to stay European? If you have to decide in a minute.
I can be straight away, I can be Italian and European at the same time, and I can even add I can be Roman at the same time. You know what I usually say? When I'm in Italy, I'm a Roman. When I'm in Europe, I'm an Italian. When I'm in the world, I'm an European. And it works.
Insieme.
When I was looking in your CV, I just realized that in fact I'm talking today to a real, real diplomat. Because when I saw everything what you did, you had a real, real diplomatic career. And then I realized that your job here is not easy at all.
Well, thank you, but it's true. I'm a professional diplomat. This is my background, and I started with an Italian foreign service, and in the past 10 years I've been working with the European Union. And certainly the role of an ambassador and of the representative of the European Union everywhere is not an easy job, and in Serbia has its own additional challenge, I would say.
The most difficult thing with your job in this moment here, because you're very communicative, and if you are communicative, right, then definitely there is an art of communication. Do you have any difficulties in this communication at all, if you want to sort out something? What is your duty?
Art of communication is an art, is a profession, but also an art, certainly. I try to be as communicative as I can. Of course, there are some important message they have to pass. Serbia, to become part of the European Union, has committed to do a number of reform in the economy, in the society, in politics, in the rural law. So there's a lot of messages were important messages. But I try also to say in a positive way, try to see the positive line. And I'm not here to lecture Serbia, I'm always here to help.
You have been very important in Brussels, in the heart of European Union, right? And now you are an ambassador right here. The big bosses are coming very often to see you here. 2 days, 3 days, here is a very big visit. It's a very important visit. How you see it? You are sitting here, and then you hear they are coming. And then you relax, and then you hear again they are coming. And they're usually coming with messages. And you are the one who is supposed to implement that messages. It's not easy for you.
No, it's not. I would say they don't come to see me. They come to see you, the Serbian, the society, the politics, the business. So they come for Serbia. They don't come with me. Certainly for me it's a great opportunity to have the highest representative of the European Union coming so often, so high level, because in Brussels the commitment is to show that Serbia is very important for us, and you show the importance, not only make statement, as you say, but also come and visit, come in person, talk, discuss, make plan together, and also look what else is to be done. So I'm happy. I never sit down because there's always a visit coming. I can hardly sit down. I was checking today in the past 8 months since I've been here. I had a number of very important visitors. Serbia had a very important visitor from European Union, including 10 days ago President Juncker for the first time ever in Serbia, and 3 weeks before President Tajani, President of the European Parliament, who was again for the first time ever in Belgrade in this capacity. We have other visit coming soon in the next month. So I think this is a very great moment for for the EU and Serbia. I'm happy to be in the middle of this. We don't rest.
Lasciatemi cantare con la chitarra in mano. Lasciatemi cantare, sono un italiano.
Your Excellency, you have been in Australia.
Yes.
Right? You have to agree that a job in Australia and a job in Serbia, you say, is different.
Yes. Can I also say that the coffee in Australia and the coffee in Serbia are the same, and I can pour you some coffee?
Can
I?
Can
because
we, a tiny
this, this is my... It's my Italian machine. Eh? This is an, this is the way we prepare the coffee in Italy, with the mocha, it's called.
Buongiorno Italia, buongiorno Maria, con gli occhi pieni di malinconia, buongiorno Dio.
Everybody says that we are in a very, very specific situation. I'm living in this country and I was always in a specific situation. Before, I recall that on the West, I was warned that my country is enormously important from the strategical point of view, that we are between the East and the West.
Serbia is very important for a number of reasons. It's is a country placed in the middle of the region, is an important economy, is an important political player. Has always been an important, historical importance in the past. So I would say the change, the importance is a little bit different now, because we are not living in the Iron Curtain any longer, thanks God. And it's good for us, Serbia, is want to be part of the European Union family. So that is what is really important for us. The country want to be part of the same family, the same union, want to accept and to want act.
We would like to be.
Exactly. That's why we are bringing Serbia to the European Union. So this is for us what is extremely important. Not to be a border country, on the contrary, but to have a country who has become within the European Union perimeter. And that is make the Serbia and the whole region particularly important for us. Also, if you look at the geographical map, you see this part of the world surrounded by the sea. And surrounded by the European Union, so it's absolutely also from a geopolitical point of view.
Do you know how people are feeling? They feel pushed, they feel pressed, suppressed, like they have to, you know, like they have to squeeze. You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
No, I try to understand what you mean. I try to understand, but it's not a question to be pressed or to be pushed. It's a question of to be consistent with the choice you made. Also in the European Union, to be part of the European Union is not when you join the European Union you go on holidays and you say, okay, nothing else I should do. Every day there's something to be negotiated. We negotiate together the budget, the rules, how we do things together, how we change our the education and the social system. We also do together in the European Union. That's why we every day is a part of the conversation around 28 countries who try to find it. It succeeds most of the time to find a common way. So the European Union didn't exist before. It's the most advanced way of keeping people, countries, societies together. And find always a common agreement. So the push is not to change Serbia, it's to say, having Serbia committed to be part of the European Union, a number of reform needs to be done. So in that sense, the accession comes with reform. So when we talk about date, about Serbia is coming to the European Union very soon, and so on and so forth, maybe the pressure will be to do more in a reduced time frame, but it's not a push for squeezing. On the contrary, it's to enlarge. We want the European to be enlarged to Serbia.
So does it mean that we must not take sides and we must not have a choice? We can stay what we are. Can we stay what we are?
The geography cannot be moved. So in the sense that no one is asking Serbia to move on one side or on the other side. What I'm asking, we are telling is that joining the European Union is joining for something, not against someone. So you should be part of the European Union. You will be one day part of European Union, provided that the rules, the values, the common understanding we have in the European Union is become part of Serbian society and so on and so forth. So it would be, the choice is to be part of the European Union, not to remain where you are.
Let me tell you, I'm a lady, and I'm not going to tell you my age, but I was counting how old I'm going to be. You know that I got sad.
In 2025?
No, you
are an evergreen, so you will be as active as you are, as interested in what the world is about. 2025 is not very far.
But can you move it a little bit closer?
It's not closer. It's not for me to say. I would say my diplomatic reply would be for Serbia to do it. It's not that we are moving the deadline because we don't want to have you sooner rather than later. The question is a reasonable amount of time where all the reform, the adjustment can be done, which means that we have said also officially that 2025 in reality means that all the negotiation, all the adjustment need to be done by 2023, because you need 2 years to have the ratification of the Serbian parliament, the European parliament, the parliament of 27 member countries. So it's a long period. So if you look to 2018, 2023, it's 5 years. You know, in 5 years, how much work need to be done? Still a lot. So the time will go very, very fast. Don't be frustrated. Be always alert, and you will see that there is the time will go very fast. But there will be a lot of work need to be done in this period.
You're helping my country in many ways. And I noticed that you're helping my country in developing the skills of people. Not only giving, but to develop the skills and to make people be ready for certain new rules of a country. Sometimes those rules are very strict, and as you know, we are not so strict people. You know, we are maybe, as you say, people which are not used to so many changes so quickly. So, what is your priority if you have to make a decision where to help and you are the one who is going to decide on that? What you personally would point out?
And I'm glad you raised this question, because I am confronted with this type of the decision every day. And I make you an example. In the European Union provide 200 million euro per year of assistance grant to Serbia, to help Serbia to adjust to the European Union. And every day I'm confronted with where we'll make the money, put the money, will make the difference. And sometimes we are building the Palace of Justice here in Belgrade. We are developing the reform of public administration with the Ministry of Public Administration. We're giving tractor to farmers. We are developing skills and giving a scholarship to Serbian students who want to study in Europe. So this is a question where we are confronted every day. And my reply is that we want to build capacity in the people that last in the future. You know, as the Chinese says, I've been posted in China, the Chinese said, if you give a man a fish, he will eat today. If you teach them how to fish, he will eat for the rest of their life. There's a weird Chinese wisdom. So to let you say, we love to invest in the people, in the capacity, as you said, in the skills that let Serbia to develop its own potential and be part of the European family for the future to come.
You did help building the Palace of Justice. It's a building. But do you know what is important with the justice? Is to teach people how to have a completely independent thinking. If you have to make a decision on something and you are a judge, you have to make a decision which is right. Can you teach people to take independent decisions in a very sensitive things, you know?
It's not
a building.
Absolutely, no. I said we built a Palace of Justice, we give scholarship to students, we do a lot, we reform the public administration, so hard reform and so-called soft reform, so we do both. If you talk about the independence of justice, it will be not for me to teach the judge how to be independent. What we are doing in as a European Union, we are supporting Serbia in changing the constitutional law of Serbia, where the independence of the judiciary system will be clearly spelled out. So there where we are helping to support Serbia to draft new article in the constitution to make the judges independent. After it would be for the judges to judge.
Yeah, and then they are going to have a palace of justice.
It helps.
Yes.
When you work in a new environment, when you're in a modern environment,
then
the court need to be infrastructure, the IT, the computer, the meeting room, also the place where you work may help you to change. It's a part of a package.
Makes you more important.
Of course. But it's a question of, rather than importance, I would say, is to provide also a physical environment where the citizen can go and hear the justice, and when the judges can deliver justice in a place which is efficient, in a place which is secure, in a place where all the utilities work, where the IT works. So it's a place where the justice is like in a hospital. Everybody wants to go in a hospital, working, clean, efficient hospital. The patient feel better, the doctor feel better. I think the investing in infrastructure is hard, but also some social and human addition. So when we on the reform of the justice, where we are providing a lot of effort, we are doing both the soft skill, but also the hard. So it is a complex exercise, but we are very happy of what we are doing.
You know, I wanted to ask you that you take me to Ovča, and you know why? Because when somebody is devastated, when somebody went through a huge, painful, personal crisis, because not to have a home, not to have, you know, it's so
terrible.
And this is where we are going to go.
We go together and we see how we can help people, how we can ensure their dignity, which is the first important thing. Hi, Rebecca. Mira, it's my wife, Rebecca.
Mira Polak,
hello. Doing the interview.
I'm interviewing your husband.
Okay, she treated me very well.
I hope so.
No, the thing is that I saw him on a very official statement, right?
Yes.
And after he is going to spend 4 years in my country on a very important issues, I would like to know who is the man, right? Who is the family? What's going on? Just to see his soul, if it's possible. Because it's very important. You know, somebody who is in a way deciding on important matters, you have to know the person. You agree with me?
Absolutely. And she's the best part of the family. And you know, she also speaks Serbian much, much better than I do, which is not difficult because I speak badly than Serbian. Rebecca is studying and learning Serbian. Maybe you can speak in Serbian.
Ja učim. Ja loše govorim, ali učim.
Učite?
Da, ja sam bila u času danas.
Imali ste čas.
Da. Ja sam
Šta je prvo što su vas naučili? Šta je prvo što su vam naučili?
Mi smo učili prvo, ne znam, kao govoriš odakle dođeš u Srbiju i šta se sviđa u Beogradu i to. I sada još 6 mjeseci učim.
Vaš muž mi je pokazao avionsku kartu.
Da.
Evo, avionsku kartu iz nekog razloga.
This is
the... You gave me this ticket, the copy of this ticket.
You know what?
Why? Why you showed me that?
It's interesting because it's. I always like to travel. This is the first ticket when I flew in 1984 outside Europe, and I flew through Belgrade to go to New York with yacht. So I think it's a sign of destiny. And 30 years or later, I'm flying back to Belgrade.
Non dimenticar means don't forget you are my darling.
This is a gift, the painting is upstairs, is a gift by Rebecca to a famous Australian designer who make a caricature of, this is me, this is Rebecca, and this is the three kids. One is born in Switzerland, one in Rome, and one in China. And this is our dog and our cat, Simba and Winston. They are part of the family. This is the press conference that the Prime Minister, Minister Yoshimi Ueda, made only 2 weeks ago, when the strategy, Western Balkan strategy was launched. This was the first press conference we made together. It was a very, very...
Recall one thing. How did you feel then? Remember?
Very well.
Well?
Yes. Addressing the press is always an...
You like it?
It's part of the job. It's always... But I like it. It's an occasion where
you have
a
little tension, what they are
always,
going to ask?
Always, of course. But
you
it's
do?
A bit. I think it's normal to have it.
Okay.
Yeah. But I can do easily, and it's becoming part of my daily job.
What you do when you have a completely unexpected question? Can you react quickly?
I have to. And I try to respond the best I can.
Questi giorni soffocati dalla solita allegria.
And here, this is the visit of the, when you know, when the ambassador arrives, introduce himself and present the letter of credence, which is the letter which is signed by your authorities.
In fact, they legalize
you. They legalize you. And basically, it's a procedure. And here, there was myself with Rebecca, who has broke her feet at the moment, but proudly stay with the crutches. And here are my three boys, and at the end of the... You introduce your family to the president. I think I was one of the first ambassadors, if not the first ambassador, to bring the kids to this ceremony. So the president was so kind to allow this change in the protocol. Jacob, my youngest boy, our youngest boy, said to the president,
he said, "Drago mi da sam vas poznavao."
And everybody was surprised because nobody knew that Jakob had learned a few things, few words in Serbian.
Con te, così lontano e diverso.
So the room where are we is that we call it the Chinese room, because there's a number of furniture, this table, this carpet, the lamp that we bought when we were in China.
Let me ask you something.
Yes.
Did you learn something in China in negotiations? Did you pick up some art or some kind of the way, because they are so specific?
I would say there is, I learned something. Time is an important element. Never be in rush. The time is a great element of in negotiation. Patient is also very, very Chinese capacity. But also there's a lot of into the Italian diplomacy, which is very, very wise than I rely upon. So with my job, I meet diplomats of all over the world, and from each of the country being, always learn something, including China.
Tell me, what is your weak point?
Who, mine?
Yes. Do you have any weak point? You're not going to tell me.
Of course. Everybody has a weak point. But I think it's a question, sometimes I'm impatient. The impatience is something that I want always to do something more, something faster. And so that's why I rely on Chinese expertise to remain patient.
But what you do with emotions?
I let my emotion flow. That is not a weakness. There is absolutely part of the strength to let... be in accordance with your emotion.
Con te, amico che credevo perso.
Is it easier to negotiate during dinners?
Of course, it's more relaxed, it's more convivial. But I would say, rather than negotiate, is to exchange views and try to present your own point of view, hoping to be persuasive.
Tell me, where are you the most successful? in which kind of a negotiation? In waiting, in persuading, in postponing? What do you think?
No, I think I'm more of the idea that we have to persuade, present our own point of view, the strength of our point of view, and see afterward the implementation. So it's not the postponing, is not part of my approach. It's also, on the contrary, say what we can do immediate, what we can do in second step. Always implementing is always a long process.
Thank you for having me in your home. And now we are going to see the buildings which you did, right?
Exactly. It's been a great pleasure to have you here with us today. I hope we will see you again in this hour.
E per te, donna senza frontiere. Per te, sotto le stesse bandiere.
The noise, they are still working.
They are still working. You know, Mira, this village was open only last week. This is an initiative that the European Union is funding in Belgrade and all over Serbia for the refugee, those people who need to find a house. And this is four building, 235 apartments.
And this is the first time you are here?
This is the very much first time here. You see, it's very impressed by the
you didn't see it before?
No, I didn't. I see
you,
only
you
in
see the project,
I
right?
see the project, and I'm glad that we are here today to meet some of the people who had been looking for a house for a number of years, and finally they found a place where they can stay. And I was telling that we have a similar project in Zemun, which will be for 270 apartments. And we have a project similar to this all over Serbia. I think at the end of the day we will give more than 6,000 apartments. Fabrizi, hi.
Milena.
Milena, najte
se.
Dobar
dan.
Da uđemo?
Može, može.
Kad ste se uselili?
Odmah čim smo dobili ključe.
Kada je to bilo?
To je bilo utorak.
Utorak, jel?
Dobar dan, se Fabrizi. Dobar dan. Hi.
Ćao.
Ćao. Hello. Boj, ćao. Najte se. How do you find the...
Pita kako vam se sviđa. Fantastično.
Okay.
A gdje ste ranije bili, da ste se mučili?
Jesmo.
Pričajte, kako je bilo?
Bili smo, privatno smo živjeli, plaćali smo.
So they lived privately and did pay for the flat?
Vlaga je bila, deca su bila bolesna.
The kids were very sick.
Sama ja ih izdržavam.
And she's the only one who is supporting the children. Jeste se nadali da ćete dobiti ovo?
Pa nisam baš.
She was not expecting that she's going to.
I'm glad. I see her, you're smiling. Very, very, very. And the kids go to school nearby? Good. By on foot?
Ovdje mi je blizu, njemu je blizu ovdje ide u školu.
I mama i papa always been with you.
Jer su tata i mama uvek bili sa vama?
Yes.
Oh. I'm very glad it's the first time I come here because...
Kada je prvi put je ovdje došao, znate, on...
We were discussing with Mira, I was interested to see finally the real people who live in the houses.
Teo da vidim ljude koji su se uselili.
Well, this is the first time that I visited these apartments. Sometimes you see numbers, you see square meters, you see money, but you never see the possibility to see what we have done with this money. And you see, with this money, we are very proud that we gave a roof to the people, we gave a house to people who haven't been in the house, The house is modern, it'll be empty. I think we need to see us also the generosity of the Serbian people to help those families with furniture, with everything that this family needed.
Razmislit ću ja nešto, da vidim sa svojim drugaricama, da vam skupim neki namještaj. I said that I'm going to do something with my friends to try to see some furniture.